reminds me of, you know, you know, in church, and you got that one auntie or that one uncle, them man hands, and the pastor will be like, everybody clap your hands for Jesus. They'll be like, you just hear one tambourine sounding. Ah, too much, it's too much, it's too much. Put this phone on silent, you know. You know when that holla bling. Oh yeah, I got a new phone case, guys. Do you like it? I don't know if it's like focusing or whatever, but yeah, that's it. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So glad to see you again. Yeah, so I'm back now with a more serious video. You know, it's not everyday banter and joke. Sometimes let's talk real life. So today I'm gonna talk about the reason why I have not told my Nigerian parents that I have a YouTube channel. Let me just rewind back to when I was in high school. So in high school I took drama as one of my GCSE subjects. Got an A star in the performance air. So I took drama as a GCSE and I loved it. And not only did I take drama, like every single Black History Month I would always do a drama play. Obviously I was the Nigerian grandma. If you know, you know. It's on YouTube somewhere, but I'm not gonna tell you where it is because yeah, I've come a long way from there. Also, I was involved in a theatre production, Annie the Musical. I was in that as well. So I was very active performance-wise, you know. Then I did A-levels and I regret not choosing drama. I really regret that. So in A-levels, I chose all the sciences and maths. What a choice. I didn't do any drama. I didn't do any creative subjects at all. It was literally science and maths. Okay, so then I was thinking, raw, like my creativity is being suppressed and compressed. So I decided to make my first Vine. And if you know, if you have me on Vine, you know that Vine, I did for the Vine, I shall not do it. Did for the Vine, I shall not do it. It did for the Vine, I shall not do it. Hey, what a Vine, yeah. So that Vine blew, like I didn't know it was gonna blow, like it blue. So I was thinking, oh okay, well, you know, I'm good at this kind of stuff, innit? So let me continue. So I just started doing a bit of Vine here and there, nothing serious. Even till now I don't do any like serious Vine, like, you know, like Tommy Expensive, they do serious Vines, like they're dedicated to their Vine channel. I'm not, it's just there for bands and I feel like it, I'll put something up, you know. So I started doing that and I started doing videos on Twitter. Some of them will bang a lot, some of them weren't. I never did it for it to bang, I just did it to express myself, you know. So now I've come to university and now I chose civil engineering, more science, more physics, more maths, you know. Something also, obviously I'm thinking, okay, let me just start my YouTube channel, okay, because I've always wanted to do that. I couldn't do it at home because obviously my mum would see the camera, she would see the light, you know, and she would make me stop. So now I'm in uni and here I am doing YouTube. We thank God to give God all the glory. Okay, so why haven't I told my dad? Okay. In high school, I used to put videos up on Facebook. I had my dad on Facebook. My dad saw it. My dad made me deactivate Facebook until I finished my GCSEs. So I didn't have Facebook for like a year because he didn't want me to embarrass myself. Now, do I agree with what he did? To an extent, yes, but no at the same time. Yes, I agree because yeah, I should have been concentrating on my GCSEs instead of me posting videos on Facebook, okay? No, because I felt like that's just how I am at the end of the day. Like, you can try and stop me from being who I am, but you can't, because it's always gonna come out. Like, there's only so much you can do to someone until they show their true colors and show who they truly are, you know. He clearly does not like the idea of me posting videos at all, full stop. Yeah, I don't know why. Maybe he feels like it will affect my future, or like employers would see my videos or anything, but I never did anything illegal. I'm just being me, you know. And he knows that I'm into art, he knows I'm into drama, he knows I'm into performances. Like, he knows the character I am. Yeah, he knows that I'm not a normal girl. He knows that I'm quite flamboyant, to say the least, you know. And all of his family as well, they all banter. That's where I got my funniness from his side of the family. So it's kind of surprising that, you know, he doesn't want me to, I don't know, express myself. But that was a long time ago anyways. That was 4 years ago that happened. So I don't know about now. I'm not sure. I don't know. I feel like if I was to tell my dad, he'll be like, you need to be focusing on your book. You are paying £9,000 a year. Focus on your education. Then after, then you can do what you want. But first of all, you need to get this degree. That's what I think my dad would say. But the reason why I do not agree with that is because everyone is so focused on the future. Don't miss the present, okay? Like, what if I don't live till then? God forbid, hopefully, you know, I live until I should die. But what if I don't live till then? I want to die knowing that, yes, I lived my life being me, you know? Not stopped by anybody else. No disrespect to my dad. I love my dad to bits. He's so encouraging and everything like that. But I just feel like you shouldn't let your parents tell you, don't be who you are. Because at the end of the day, you're living your own life. You know, obviously, your parents need to listen to them because they can give you really good advice. But at the same time, I still feel like your parents could come between you and your destiny. The reason why I haven't told my mom I have a YouTube channel is because, I don't know, I just feel like she'll make me stop it. You know, like, I had a YouTube channel before with my friend. It wasn't like anything serious. It was just banter that we used to do around the school and stuff. And she knew about that and she used to watch that and laugh. So it's not as if, like, yeah, she liked that. She enjoyed that. So I don't know. I think she wouldn't mind me having one, but I think she'd want to watch them constantly. That's why I'm just watching what I say in here. Because if I go and say something, I should be like, eh? You did what? You did what when you were 16 years old? You did who? You did how? Like, yeah, so, yeah, I'm a good child anyways, but, yeah, I don't know, I feel like she'll be more supportive. I feel like she'll be more understanding, like, because I lived with her, so she knows who I am, she knows how I am. All I've got to say is that don't let anybody come between you and your destiny. No one, whether that is your parents, your brother, your sister, your family, your friends, your partner, don't let anyone, because you're living for yourself. They're not living your life, you're living your life. And I believe that God has given each and every one of us a talent, yeah? And I do honestly believe that my talent is performing, it's speaking, it's art, you know? And anybody that knows me personally, they can say the same thing, because when I perform to the best of my ability, and I'm saying, sorry, I don't know why I did that, but yeah. Oh, I feel like God has given us a talent and you should use it, okay? Your talent may not be your parents' talent. That's why they may not understand why you do certain stuff. But in the future, they will understand. When I'm, you know, in my Nollywood movie, raking in all the peas, they'll be like, oh, my good daughter, I've always believed in you, innit? I'll see you that day, innit? I'll see you that day. I feel if you've got a talent, use it. Soon, they will understand. And at the end of the day, I'm 19 years old. I think I can be who I can be now. You know, I've been, you know, compressing it for too long. Like, let me just... I was going to do this video anyways, but coincidentally, my mum called me last week. And this is how the conversation went. Ade, what are you doing? I'm just chilling in my room. What are you doing on YouTube? What do you mean? What are you doing on YouTube? I saw you on YouTube. No, you didn't. You didn't see me on YouTube. I didn't see you. No, you didn't see me. Oh, okay. Good night. What? Like, did she see me or not? Like, I was so confused. I was thinking, oh my God, what has just happened? You know, I was thinking, oh my God, my life is over. She has found out about my YouTube channel. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? I'm gonna have to like stop doing YouTube and everything. Like, I just got so worried and I was panicking. I was like, oh my God, my life is over. Then the next day, my brother messaged me. He was like, oh yeah, mom said that her friend saw me on YouTube. So she asked me what my YouTube channel name is, and he convinced her that it was my old YouTube videos. So yeah, exactly. So this confirms why I don't want to tell her, because she seems so angry. Why would you be angry when your daughter is just doing something that she enjoys? You know, and obviously I always put my books first before YouTube, you know. YouTube is just a hobby. It's not as if like, oh, it's preventing me from doing the best in uni. No, you can't. I'm not here in uni just to study at the end of the day. I'm here to gain experience, yeah. Well, that is all from me. Comment below what you want to see in the future. Oh my days, where is it? So I don't know if you've realized, but recently the wind has been so marsh. The wind was very marsh. I tried to move, but the wind was still taking me back. Oh god, the wind has been like a lot. And I was walking home with my umbrella. I was walking. The wind was trying to push me like Mary Poppins. I was like, no, it's not happening today. I have the arm strength, you know what I'm saying? So yes, yeah, so I was walking. The wind was like kind of pushing me back, but I was still moving forward. Then, I don't know how, but my hair got stuck on my umbrella, but I didn't know it was stuck on there. So I was still moving. Then the umbrella decides to go backwards. My hair, literally, my wig nearly came off in public. Like, my hair was literally hanging on the string, fam. I was like, oh my god, no way. This can't be happening to me. So now I know if it's snowing, I'm a finna wear a hat. Because I don't want my wig to be falling off in public. Because that's not cute. That's not cute, boo-boo. That's not cute. But yeah, that's enough of me today. I will see you later, okay? Bye. Until next time, I need to stop dabbing. Like, this needs to go. I need to create my own dance so it can go viral. And they'll be like, eh, it's Miss Nigeria that created that dance. I'm like, yes, it's me. I don't know what dance maybe I should create. Oh, okay. My favorite dance move ever is this. We know about that dance move. Get to know. Hey, you do that in the club, you will scatter everybody. Yeah, I'm telling you. I told you, innit? It came from me first, innit? So I'm letting you use my dance move, innit? The shoulder. Hey. Hey. Oh, God. That's how you get the ladies. Man, them, you just do that in the club. All the ladies will say, oh, ho, 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 ho. You know? Trust me. I told you, innit?